in prison, you serve your time. If you're not there without any parole, or you're gonna time, you're gonna get out. Come, can somebody say amen? So the Lord helped me to preach on today. God will get me out, not in your time, but in His time. Can somebody praise God? We knew that Joseph ended up in prison because Potiphar's wife lied on him, and his master did not examine the condition, but he just sent Joseph straight to prison, even without a trial, even without questioning Brother Joseph. But because he believed his lying wife, everybody say, believe his lying wife. He accepted the word of the woman, knowing that the Lord was with Brother Joseph, and he sent him into prison. But the Bible said, the Lord was with Joseph. Verse 20 says, and Joseph's master took him and put him into the prison. The prison, a place where the king's prisoners were bound. And he was there in the dungeon. So Joseph was not even at a comfortable place. Now these days you have some sophisticated prison. It's like you're at a hotel. It was nothing like that. Because the prisoner, now you have television. Your man shop, you have internet. Amen. You get 3 meals a day. Some people believe that they are better off in prison than outside. Because in prison, you guarantee a meal. Now, in Joseph's days, he had no such luxury. It was in the dungeon. It was an awful place he was. That's where he was placed. But thank God, it doesn't matter where you are. All you want to know is that the Lord is with you. Can somebody praise God? I know sometimes some of us, we found ourselves in certain situation, and some may wonder, how did you get there? Why did they put you there? But you are there for a reason. And certain things you and I may not be able to understand right now, but the sister song farther along will know all about it. Father along we'll understand why. He said, cheer up, my brother, live in the sunshine. We'll understand it all by and by. So Joseph was in a dirty place. He was at a place where no human being would want to go. But could I tell somebody, it was part of God's plan. If you are not spiritual, you and I will not understand certain things when the Lord is working. And we may end up blaming individuals, not knowing it is God who is working on my behalf. But Pastor, what are you talking about? How could it be God? Let the woman lie on me and send me to prison. Now, God didn't tell Potiphar's wife to lend Brother Joseph. But the Bible says all things work together for good for those that love God, for those who are called according to His purpose. And as I would often say, nothing happened to you by chance or by accident. It is by design. Once you're called by His name and walking right, God will take care of you everywhere you go. So while he was in prison, the Bible says, and the Lord was with him. Some of you, you may find yourself in prison, meaning from the outside world, locked off from other people. It seems like you are by yourself. You may feel isolated, but once you know that the Lord is with you, then everything is all right. Your husband don't have to be with you. Your wife don't have to be with you. Your pastor, your children, your brethren. All I want to know is that the Lord is with me, because one with God is the majority. Come on, somebody, give him praise here today. The Bible said when Joseph got to prison, It says, and the keeper of the prison committed to Joseph's hand all the prisoners. So right away, he became supervisor. Why? Because the Lord was with him. Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, take the promotion that God gives you. Hallelujah. In your eyes, it may seem small. You see, God has to check us out with the small things before he give us the big things. Now, some of us just want to see, to be seen from the podium. But brother, if you can stay in your seat and stay there and take up a little leaf, take up a piece of trash, get the broom and sweep the place. God said, I can trust you with something else. Come on here. God said, before I put you up here, I'm going to test you out down there. Can somebody give God a praise? So the prisoner, Joseph was in charge of the prisoners. So everything that went on in the prison, it was under Joseph's command. Can you say amen? Look at this. He was not even Egyptian. He was a Hebrew. He was a stranger in Egypt. But you see, the Lord was in the man. Hallelujah. Oh, help me, Holy Ghost. The Lord was living on his inside. And the keeper of the prison, oh, this is a man that can be trusted. Glory be to God. And when we find people that can be trusted, we should say, look, man, I know you're able to do this. Hear me today. There are certain people who are not qualified to do certain things, but because we think they should be in that position, we put them there. But God know, and even other people know, they're not qualified. Amen. And if some people don't get certain position, they back away from even working with along other people. But look at this. The prisoner know that this man, who's in charge of the prison, knew, he knew that there was something about this man. Now, if you find somebody who can lead better than you, let them lead, man. Come on. If they can do the thing better than you, say, man, go ahead. I don't feel jealous. Come on here, somebody. I remember, and I won't forget this, when Bishop was ordaining us, he said to us, grow. He said, grow past me. He said, none of you are a threat to me. He said, I know what God calls me for. Hallelujah. Now, if you know what he called you for, then there's no need to be jealous when God bless your brother, when God bless your sister, when God bless the uncle, when God bless the pastor, when God bless the choir, when God bless the soloist. Man, if the anointing of God is on them, if them bless me, bless too. Come on, somebody, because I'm going to get some of what is on them. Say yes, somebody. I'm not a professional player. Brother Darren is better than me. Amen. And I'm not going to act like I can't play better than Brother Darren. So most of the time I prefer him play. There are certain songs he probably can't manage, because it's new to him what me can manage. Amen. But he's more skillful. He's more stylish. I don't want to sit and listen to the man. Come on. You recognize that he can do it. And you let the man flow. Come on here, somebody. I'm going to run and come to let me play. Make me a pastor. No. He can do it better than I. So let him flow. Come on, somebody. All you need to do is to compliment the person. Come on, somebody. Play on. Sing on, sister. Preach, sister. Bless him, Lord. Say yes, somebody. So the keeper of the prison knew that this man, although he came in as a prisoner, but there is something about him. I'm gonna set him in charge. Hear this, pastor. Well, it doesn't matter what time you come in. I don't care if you're here 15 years ago or 10 years ago. God doesn't look on that. It's who can do it. Talk to Pastor DC. It's who can do it. And my God, You know, I saw Deaconess came to baptism yesterday, and I know she came later. And I said to her, CM Penny, come on, somebody. Although she came in late, but the CM Penny, the mere fact that she shows up, it means she wants to be there. So God said, CM Penny, you see, some of us were looking on years in church. And so because you're here for years, it should be your honey said neighbor and a circle. Tell somebody, say, Sister Lynn, tell them, say, say, go. Tell them, say, it's what God wants. Because, you know, I was preaching at Pastor Mackenzie Church on Tuesday night about David. And when God sent Samuel to Jesse's house, it was an anointed service. And the one that to be anointed was not even in the service. And he was the washbelly. He was the last one. And when Eliab passed through, Samuel said, surely the Lord's anointing is on him. God said, Samuel, the one I say I will show you. Come on here, somebody. So it's not the years. It's not how old you are. It's who God qualifies. Can I preach to somebody? It's not who man's qualified, but who God qualifies. So when they sent for Brother David, when he came in, God says, arise, anoint him, because this is he. So it was not Eliab. It was not Abinadab.
Thank you for watching the hour of deliverance. Well, I know you are blessed to talk to him. It's time to go. But you can get a copy of this day by calling the number 718-733-6214. God bless you. If you go to our church home, come and join us. All of our contact numbers are for your information.
Not the other four, but the one to get the job was out there in the field is the youngest one. Better hear me well. Some of you are only holding opposition until the right person come. Are you hearing me, somebody? So don't feel too comfortable where you are. Just praise God in your office. Glorify God and wait until your time come to get out, because surely God knows when to get me out. Can you say yes? Say yes. He was a stranger, but the man knew, man, the qualities that I saw in you, you're fit for the job. Take my position. Did you know what he did? The man stepped down. He demoted himself and said, Joseph, take my position. Take over. Because what I see in you, what I feel, oh God Almighty, what I feel when you come around me, these type of prisoners, what I have, I can't deal with them. But there's something that you have that can deal. Yes, Holy Ghost, thank you. There are certain people can't operate around other individuals because of what them have to offer. Some of you too rough, you too. But there are some people that just love your spirit. They like how you talk. They like how you act like how you love me. Come on, praise God. Come on, here, somebody. It's because you got to know how to move with people.